Hey there, TRASTRA fans. The craziness of the last few days is as entertaining as it is horrifying. As in, look how little we actually need to send the entire market into an utter frenzy. And following the highly anticipated Bitcoin 2024 event, the crypto community was on the high, pushing Bitcoin to a lofty 70K per coin. The romance of Bitcoin seemed unstoppable, but if you check out this absolutely brilliant, criminally underwatched Bitcoin 2024 highlight reel from this dude who calls himself a techno-ethicist American scream or whatever, you will know what I'm talking about when I say beware of the crazies taking over the cryptoverse.
We started with a dream to build a community focused on Bitcoin.
But our country is blessed to have the extraordinary talent, energy, and genius represented in this room. Not all of you.
Welcome to the great state of Tennessee.
Nobody knows what's going on.
I cannot tell you how happy and excited we are to welcome you to the land of liberty, freedom, and prosperity.
So if you really want freedom, you want to smell the volcano of freedom, move to El Salvador, fuck the U.S.
Freedom.
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 Individual freedom.
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 Liberty and freedom.
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 The freest
freedom.
Sounds like economic freedom.
It's freedom money.
Liberty.
Freedom.
Freedom.
Ultimately, the number one value that underlines everything here is freedom.
Freedom.
Decentralized.
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 Decentralization.
Self-sovereignty.
Sovereignty.
Self-sovereignty.
Self-sovereignty.
Liberty and freedom.
Self-sovereignty.
Taxation is theft. People that are sucking at the teeth.
Number go up.
It's going to the moon.
Money printer.
Money printer.
Money printing.
Hello, everybody. It's good to be with you.
Beware of those. I mean, this thing is hilarious. I'm going to include the link in the description. It's like 13 minutes long. You'll enjoy every second of it. Anyway, in the real world, tech stocks were taking a major hit because Warren Buffett, that old fart, knows something. He always knows something. So he started selling his rock-solid Apple shares, which sent shockwaves through the entire stock market, triggering a massive sell-off. Global markets nosedove, and the cryptocurrency sector was not spared. Bitcoin plunged more than 25% over the last 7 days, dragging down other major cryptocurrencies. Ether, for instance, experienced its steepest fall since 2021. Freaking 32%. Incredible. I mean, I knew it was going to tank immediately after Trump shut his mouth in Nashville. I just didn't think it was going to be this bad. So in Asia, the situation was equally grim. The Nasdaq 100 contracts dropped over 2.6%. The Japanese market was hit hard, with the topics and Nikkei indices tumbling 20% from their July peaks, making a significant bear market territory. The sell-off was not confined to equities alone. Bonds rallied as investors rushed to havens, highlighting the growing risk aversion in global markets. And again, this aversion put immense pressure on Bitcoin, leading to its heftiest weekly loss since the infamous collapse of the FTX exchange in 2022. So adding to the turmoil, geopolitical tensions in the Middle East have been escalating, further unsettling global markets. Investors are on edge, and the uncertainty is palpable. I mean, in this climate, it's no surprise that riskier assets like cryptocurrencies are taking a major beating. To sum up, the euphoria from Bitcoin 2024 was short-lived. The reality of the stock market and strategic moves by investment moguls like Warren Buffett and others, actually, have brought a harsh reckoning. Though a symbol of the financial revolution, Bitcoin is once again proving to be highly susceptible to broader market dynamics. And once again, we're seeing its roaring shortcomings as a possible unit of exchange, you know? Money. So as the saying goes, what goes up must come down. And right now, both tech stocks and cryptocurrencies are feeling the gravity, and you are about to experience the rest of episode 123 of your beloved TRASTRA Newsreel. So just to recap, we're at 53K right now, as of this Monday afternoon. Several factors contributed to this decline. I've mentioned a few in the intro monologue. Here's the rest. Disappointing non-farm payrolls data revealed that only 114,000 jobs were added in July, significantly below the anticipated figures. Additionally, the unemployment rate, I'm talking about the United States of America, of course, the unemployment rate unexpectedly rose to 4.3%, marking its fourth consecutive increase. All right, so second reason is rising recession fears. Peeps been eating cash, hence a surge in long liquidations over the past few days. Approximately $1.6 billion worth of long positions were liquidated, accounting for about 90% of total market liquidations. Just amazing. I mean, I haven't seen these figures for a while. I already mentioned the stock market decline. Here are some more deets on that. NASDAQ composite lost 2.43%, closing at 16.776. This brings its decline from a recent all-time high to over 10%. Furthermore, the Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 610 points, or about 1.5%, finishing at 39.7, with the index plunging as much as 989 points at its session low. This stock market decline has potentially spilled over into the crypto market. Against this grim backdrop, factors like Bitcoin and Ethereum ETF outflows may even seem redundant, actually. Nevertheless, they played a role. We're talking about roughly a quarter of a million in outflows, so there's a role there. All in all, we're looking at a massive liquidations of retail-heavy exchanges like Binance, where major altcoins, including Ethereum, Solana, XRP, Cardano, Dogecoin, and Shiba, saw substantial declines ranging from 20% to 50%, with about $500 billion wiped off the crypto market cap. I mean, the good news is that the brand new Trump MAGA president coin went up 165% over the last 24 hours since it was listed, so congrats to lucky investors, I guess. But if I were you, I'd be dumping this piece of shit right about now, so as not to follow the footsteps of Trump v. Harris coin, which over the last over the past 2 hours went down like a stone, 82% decline. The graph looks amazing. On July 31st, Senator Cynthia Lummis officially introduced a Bitcoin Strategic Reserve Bill, which would direct the United States government to start a Bitcoin Reserve Fund. The bill would establish a decentralized network of secure Bitcoin vaults under the control of the United States Treasury. So much for decentralization. Jesus. The bill also directs lawmakers and government officials to enact strict cybersecurity parameters and other physical security measures to ensure that Bitcoin funds are safe. Additionally, the bill laid out a goal of accumulating 1 million Bitcoin over time, or roughly 5% of Bitcoin's total supply, using existing U.S. Treasury funds to acquire the Bitcoin in amounts that mirror the U.S. Treasury's gold allocation. Lummis's bill also seeks to protect the right to self-custody in the United States. Frankly, I didn't know this right was under threat in America, so I'm not sure what she means by that. Anyway, crypto exchange ByBit has ceased offering all the products and services in France starting August 2nd at 4 a.m. French users are no longer able to make crypto purchases, open new positions, or add to existing ones on the platform. All ByBit services, including ByBit Earn and Spot products, are included in the restriction. Any unclosed positions will be automatically liquidated on August 13th at 4 a.m., after which only withdrawals will be allowed. ByBit's exit from France follows stricter licensing regulations imposed by the country in August 2023 in preparation for the European Union's markets in crypto assets, the infamous MiCA, that goes into full effect in December this year. A reminder, ByBit left the UK market last September amid new crypto marketing rules, so these people are screwed. The crypto exchange WazirX announced a socialized loss strategy on July 27th in response to the $235 million hack it suffered on July 18th, which equaled 45% of user funds. In a nutshell, to avoid a long explainer, especially since I don't entirely understand how this thing's going to play out, the strategy is this: users lock up 45% of their assets and retain full access to 55% that's left, but do not withdraw them. In exchange, they are granted priority in the distribution of future recovery funds, if they'd be so lucky to recover some or whatever. I mean, or users are allowed to access 55% of their funds and withdraw them, but they fall behind the priority list in recovery distribution compared to those who opt for the first option. I'll tell you, it's beyond me how in 2024 we're still not crystal clear on why keeping your assets on an exchange is a stupid idea. Here's what I recommend. Use TRASTRA. We offer custody by BitGo, an industry leader in cryptocurrency custody solutions who issue multi-sig wallets that reliably and securely manage your private keys. No hacks in 7 years in the business, not a single one. So you also get 2FA, you get fingerprint authentication, the whole nine yards in terms of security. We support 7 major cryptocurrencies: Bitcoin, Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, XRP, USDC, and USDT in ERC-20 and TRC-20 token format. The virtual Visa card is coming in a couple of weeks. For now, you can use IBAN accounts for Euro transactions and our Crypto Swift solution for worldwide transfers. So you're basically covered on that end as well. In other words, I think it's a near perfect solution for buying, selling, and exchanging cryptocurrencies. And most importantly, using them the way they were intended from the very moment Satoshi put digital ink on digital paper. We make crypto work for you in daily life, not as a speculative investment, but as an instrument of peer-to-peer value exchange. So use it. Listings for pairs of Donald Trump's limited edition orange Bitcoin-themed sneakers have already made their way onto eBay, with scalpers hoping to sell their spot in the pre-order queue for as much as $2,500. Spot, mind you, not the actual pair of shoes, but the spot in the queue. So I guess I've checked it out. Right now, there's only 2 listings on eBay for the spot in the queue left. I mean, they're listed as orange-colored high tops, but the reality is, again, it's the spot in the queue. But the this thing's already sold out, so I'm not sure what the deal there is. Probably some sort of scam or a joke, I don't know. So just a reminder, Trump's Bitcoin-themed footwear went live for pre-order on the official Trump sneakers website on July 31st with a limited edition run of 1,000 pairs, just 1,000 pairs. They sold out within 3 hours of launch. Amazing. The website said 5 pairs of the limited edition shoes would be randomly signed by Trump, meaning that Trump sneakerheads would have a 1 in 200 chance of receiving a signed pair. Kind of a dubious honor, but there, you could be the one stepping out wearing Trump's signature on your ankles. And finally, Heather Morgan, aka rapper Razzlekhan.
Never forget, weirdest is most original. This song is for the entrepreneurs and hackers, all the misfits and smart slackers. Razzlekhan, the Versace better win. Come real far, but don't know where I'm heading. Motherfucking crocodile of Wall Street. Silver on my fingers and boots on my feet. Always be a goat, not a goddamn sheep. Email me, fuck your message at the beat.
Remember, she made headlines after being arrested and subsequently pleading guilty to one of the most audacious cyber heists in history, the 2016 Bitfinex hack, resulting in the theft of 120,000 Bitcoin. Back then, it was worth about $4.5 billion. So she was actually seen at Bitcoin 2024 in Nashville, which is not really a big deal because her sentencing is scheduled for November 8th, 2024. In the meantime, she's all over the Bitcoin circuit. The paranoid, self-sovereign, individual freedom-adoring Bitcoiner James Lopp offered two explanations of her presence at the shindig. She's either seeking consulting gigs in order to pay the $250,000 fine she owes to the government. She's been introducing herself as a Web3 advisor all over the Bitcoin conferences all over the world. Or she's seeking to reduce her sentence by collecting intel on behalf of the government. Yeah, that's actually a quote. Seeking to reduce her sentence by collecting intel on behalf of the government. Totally. Yeah, that's a great way to collect intel on Bitcoiners in the age of spy satellites, Prism, Upstream Collection, X, Keyscore, Boundless Informant, Tempora, and other government surveillance programs revealed by Edward Snowden. By the way, another keynote speaker at Bitcoin 2024 who actually claimed a Bitcoiner's win over government. That's what he said. We're winning. He said, we're winning over government. So instead of using all that, you send in an imminently recognizable, soon-to-be-convicted felon, supply her with a seat at Donald Trump's table, and have her poke around for a scoop. Bravo, Mr. Lopp. You did crack the case. I'm going to stop now. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully, I didn't freak you out too much. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. Be sure to follow us on social. Be sure to join our Telegram community, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.